えてのゲーム4リーチをかけているのはクレストゲーミングアクト、そしてサイドの選択権も
このゲームクレストゲーミングアクトが持っています。CGA match point here has the opportunity to take this one home。It's up to Rascal Jester to keep themselves alive here. We're seeing a familiar rounds of bans here once again. CGA banning away three picks that has led up to a lot of success on the side of Rascal Jester. While Zoe, LeBlanc, and Kalista banned away, that does mean that they are offering Aria up the Aphelios once again. And CGA continuing the priority on that set very high. So for the side of Rascal Jester, it will be up to them to figure out how they get around the kind of what seemed to be unstoppable brawling snowball that CGA had picked up last time. And as it seems right now, Varus will be picked up by the side of Rascal Jester. So Art, once again, going to be on one of those high carry champions. But what do they accompany it with? They have a couple pick options available to them, but it looks like the Rek'Sai is going to be picked up here. The jungle on R2, an infamously well-known trait of the LJL. Passing over both Jarvan and Elise, which is somewhat interesting as Elise now falling in priority in CGA. Are locking in the Kai'Sa right away. And this is rather interesting, is pushing up the priority on the Kai'Sa in this series. Now, it's a little bit interesting, although you do expect that the Varus is going bot lane if you are basing it off of past trends. It still can be somewhat of a risky pick, especially if they end up flexing the Varus to the mid lane instead and end up running something like a Caitlyn in the bot lane. That can be a very scary lane very quickly for the Kai'Sa. The Karma is picked up once again for this top lane by Cog. And with the Sylas being passed to the second round, it will not make it into this game. CGA putting priority towards that Jarvan. Want that aggressive jungler. They're willing to pay for it here by passing over the Sylas in this series, as Pantheon going to be banned away again. Now, the Pantheon is also one of those bans that I sort of question ping a little bit, especially when we've seen how consistently Kog wants to play the Karma in the top lane. CGA has not exactly any reason to believe that the Pantheon is going to be considered as the counter for the top lane. There, but respecting it all the same, the Zillion also banned away from the side of CGA, taking away a lot of those mid lane options from Aria. He is absorbing almost four bans by himself. Nautilus picked up by Rascal Jester. Once again, kind of drafting into the same style of comp, their one point that they'll be able to change up is, of course, their mid lane. And they'll need a strong mid lane counter pick here if they want to try and pull this off again, but it looks like CGA might be trying to run back the same kind of comp that they had prior, swapping out a Sejuani for a Jarvan in this series, possibly in response to seeing that Rek'Sai on R2. But CGA also locking in the Echo is actually a fine pick for the same kind of comp. It does offer now a dive threat to the side of Rascal Jester. And that is something I talked about in one of these games prior, is there's no dive threat to get onto this AD carry that you're trying to set up as a hyper carry. And now, not only does CGA have this kind of brawly comp where neither team are drafting into hard defensive tanks, but you also now have an Echo to worry about diving your AD carry and ending these fights before it even began. CGA may be making the advancement necessary. The interesting note here is that possibly this cannon does offer a little bit of extra team fight potential. You have now this kind of mix up going on where you're sending the Nautilus into the mid lane. It's a melee matchup there, but Kakog now on the cannon, if he's able to find a high team fight ultimate, that is a great way to neutralize this snowball that's walking forward into your team comp. You have the set and the Aatrox that are trying to walk in on your team, as well as the Jarvan trying to lead that charge. If the cannon is able to find a good ultimate and utilize Zhonya's, that is a huge zone of control offered up to the side of Rascal Jester. So things to look out for on both sides, and I do like the pickup of the cannon, as well as now offering the Karma as a little bit of a flex pick and moving it down towards the bottom side. The question is, will Kog be able to punish Nap hard enough on this cannon? We have seen cannons go as far as carrying entire games, as well as not doing so hot. So things to keep an eye out for in this series.
ラスカルジェスター VS クレストゲーミングアクトの試合スタートです。さあ、面白い立ち位置を取っているのはラスカルジェスター。
Rascal Jester looking to wander in here. CGA will be forced to back away. They will get a free ward out of all of it. And it looks like Rascal Jester might be looking for a little bit more as they sneak their way around to the red buff side here. もう一度トリンケット、will they be able to find any members? Does not look like it for now. But two deep wards early on will help kind of keep an eye on Yoshi's pathing. And Rascal Jester, it looks like they will actually be staying for the red buff on this side of the map here. So a little bit of the same kind of idea from CGA's comp, especially with the way Aria likes to play Sylas. It's almost kind of a repeat of what we had seen before, where Aria at multiple points was kind of diving to get kills. He was diving on the Jarvan in the early side. He even got the E chains to land onto Art in the last fight there to pull it out. Now Aria on the Echo is a bit heavier of a dive threat, but still offers that kind of blow up potential to the side of Rascal Jester or to any of the two to either of the squishy members on the side of RJ. Meanwhile, for the side of RJ, they have drafted themselves into a little bit better of a team fighting comp, as well as kind of changing the script a bit here, is that Art is no longer the focus as a hyper carry, as he is looking to go down the lethality Varus path. So kind of changing things up here. The only issue is that the question sort of becomes, how does this all work together? You have a team fighting cannon, you have Hachimecha, this early aggressive jungler, and then you have a lethality Varus to try to finish people off. Remains to be seen, but for now, Kai'Sa not one to want to weather the storm of this poke war in the bot lane. Kind of coming up Rascal Jester's favor for now. Piercing Arrow finds his way through. Comet luckily going onto Grendel there to keep Gengo a little bit of his HP left, but right now, Rascal Jester are in full control of these waves. Art is already level 3 to Gengo's level 1 as the wave is coming in here. Are they going to look for an early dive opportunity? Ninja is rotating down as well. They can look for something. They have a decent enough wave accumulated here. Gengo and Grendel are going to back up. TP comes in. That is going to be Arya making that call, but RJ will take a free teleport and back away on that account. Free summoner burned very early on in this series is not a terrible look for the side of RJ as Hachimecha grabs up the bot lane scuttle and looks to return to scouting around on the bottom side, this time finding Yoshi off of the Tremor Sense. Might be able to look for a fight here as Gengo does not have enough HP to really try and contest a fight. It looks like Hachimecha is going to try to find his way around here. Is in perfect position for this counter gank to work out as Art looking to just be a little bit aggressive, but it, now the turn onto Grendel, a teleport coming in as well just for safekeeping. Ninja is here. That is going to be Hachimecha picking up that early first kill. Great job from the side of Rascal Jester to kind of bait the members of CGA in there. Hachimecha recognizes the situation, loops back around to just wait in the brush. Vivid pulls Grendel in, kind of baits him into looking for a fight because they know they have the jungler coming. But with Hachimecha there just a little bit faster, that fight is able to easily turn in their favor. As Grendel looks to try and hold the wave for his AD carry, Art looking to try and harass him a bit for his dealing actually a huge chunk of damage. Luckily he is set, so does have the passive to try and heal him back up, but and also just look to take a back if he so chooses.
このところドラゴンの獲得そしてボットでは CSさですよね。さらには経験値面でもかなりロストしてしまってますから1レベル差以上もう2レベル差ついてしまってますね。言語としては軽を購入してなんとか後半に向けてのゴールドをつないでいきたいというビルドオーダーになっています。And now
Art not being able to get a back off here is in a little bit of an odd pit situation where he is not able to get a back, so he is out of refill pots. He will be stuck with the mana he has. But Arya looking to find out Hachimecha here, they're going to go for a dive onto Kogkog. He is level 6, so he does have the ultimate. Flashing forward with that one, Hachimecha is going for the knockup here onto Arya, but forced to flash back away. Good avoidance on the chrono break from the Echo there. It looks like they will back out as 5. A little bit of an ambitious dive, but Rascal just to deter that with an early kind of with checking them early as the engage comes in onto Art. Knows he does not have a whole lot of HP. A beautiful sidestep from Art there. He will be able to find the kill. Getting punched down by Set now. Grendel looks for more, but Art can put up a bit of a chase there. A beautiful play there from Art to sidestep Gengo's W, which would have made all the difference in that fight there. But ends up finding the advantages. Now Gengo can try and freeze out the wave here and hopefully pick himself up some CS. He's been losing to the poke war of this bot lane. Art opting in to the lethality Varus here is proving itself to be rather valuable as Kai'Sa, not exactly a champion that can weather poke very well, but Grendel on this set in support, without it being a Kalista that can that can move the set very far in, there's not a whole lot of options on the side of CGA to answer that much poke. They don't have a lot of options to take an engage very heartily that they can exploit the fact that Art does not have the kind of all-in potential. Meanwhile, they're just eating poke after poke between Karma and this lethality Varus. Now with level 6 though, does kind of offer a little bit of benefit where now Gengo can utilize the ultimate to get on to Art in the back, can get behind the Karma onto Art and force the all in a little bit easier. The question is, how do you find it? How do you find these fights, especially with Grendel no flash to speak of for some time? Going to be a tough ask on the side of CGA as Hachimecha pokes his head around the bot lane, seeing what's what with his friendly bot laners. He's going to look to set up possibly a lane gank here. It looks like Aria and Yoshi are both pathing here, so possibly a good read from Hachimecha. As he wanders back up, he will find Aria there. Yoshi rotating down here. Cataclysm goes in onto Art. The W missing, but the E lands, so Gengo does have the ultimate to get in onto him. Now Vivid is left alone and between a rock and a hard place. Nowhere to really run as the kill goes over to Gengo there. Hachimecha leaves just a little bit too early to help that play and ends up actually losing a decent amount of HP to Aria as well. But two kills going over to CGA and a decent amount of turret plate time for themselves as well. They will take a back on that account. And in this sort of like awkward place in this mid lane, you have to wonder, what does the Nautilus start doing for your comp? While it is doing a good job of kind of keeping Aria locked up and is doing a decent job when he doesn't have ultimate, the gank potential is not exactly here. His ninja might be biting himself a bit in the wrong spot there, taking a couple turret shots there. Aftershock doing wonders for keeping him high HP. Grendel here to hold the wave. Ninja's going to go for an engage onto him. Teleport comes back. It is going to be Aria coming back in, but the ultimate, the showstopper, coming in to carry Hachimecha out of that one. W narrowly being avoided, but he will just be burned down by the other two members in the meantime. Nowhere to run for Hachimecha there. And CGA find themselves a return kill off of the engage from Ninja, thinking that Grendel was alone in there, possibly miscommunicating the cooldown of Aria's teleport. And that will mean that Protobelt is completed for Echo in this mid lane, and is a decent amount of gold in by now. Kog looking for a backup, likely has his Protobelt as well. But with Cloud Drake started up here, Razgul Jester are looking to take this one down early. Not exactly the fastest dragon clear with the lethality Varus, but fast enough to get the job done, as members of CGA seem fairly unconcerned about passing over the Cloud Drake here. And Ocean Drake going to be spawned up here. Now, somewhat of an interesting scenario is that Razgul Jester, while they did get the first two souls and they put themselves closer to the soul objective, they don't exactly have the best users for the ocean soul. Sure, it will keep Ninja and Hachimecha alive in the front line long enough, but Kog and Art's damage is very bursty and isn't exactly geared to take advantage of the ocean soul to take longer engagements. But speaking of engagements, Gengo getting rooted up by the Chains of Corruption, but the teleport from Nap will deter them for now. And once again, Razgul Jester are looking for plays onto this bot lane, but then are backed off by the teleports of CGA. Nap looking for something here, trying to scout out into that bush. And members of Rascal Jester are here, but how will they find something out? Meanwhile, Yoshi is just enjoying his time to freeform on the top side of the map here. Possibly recognizing that nothing is really going to break out of that one. Rascal Jester, not exactly going to turret dive 4v4 or 4v5. So right now it looks like everyone will somewhat return to neutral state, but Rascal Jester are staying around actually. They want to try and take down this turret. Hook from Ninja's not going to land, but he will take a decent amount of damage for it. Chains pulling him back in on that one. Looks for the re-engage here, but ends up actually eating a stun for it. But now Kogkog is in with the ultimate. That will be Hachimecha picking up the Aatrox there. Gengo picking up a kill of his own. Aria going down. And this is now CGA's time to shine. As Art is caught on the wrong end. All members of Rascal Jester are in the wrong side of the jungle. Gengo's looking for more here, but he's not going to be able to find himself any cannons for breakfast there. The W. Not going to finish him off, but meanwhile, Yoshi finding a kill there. And if you are Yoshi in that series, you're very happy about the outcome of that one. But we'll watch this fight break out one more time as Rascal Jester are just really posturing just a bit too aggressively. And Hachimecha comes over the wall, and it looks good for Rascal Jester as they start this one out. But Gengo is untouched this entire time, and a huge ultimate just blows up a lot of the members of Rascal Jester. And meanwhile, Gengo is just enjoying his time to be full HP and just pick away at all the members of CGA. Like I was saying, I think Yoshi got the best end out of all of that. He got to clear out the entire top side from Rascal Jester, clear his blue and bot, and then when he returns, he's able to even pick up a couple kills. So CGA are finding themselves a nice gold lead, and the Chains of Corruption go wide. A botched engage, but the Death Charge is here to kind of find something from the ashes. Callista gets Kaisa. Second time I've done that. Kaisa will get targeted down there, and it looks like Rascal Jester will be able to pick up a turret off of it. But first turret, having already gone over to the mid lane, not exactly the worst position to be in for Rascal Jester. But not exactly the gold bounty that you would like either. CGA taking their control of the top half of this map. As Aria looks to knock down a top turret, trading a 1-for-1 overall.
And
CGA, although they are currently in the lead, they still do need to be a bit on the careful side for now. While Rascal Jester is a bit behind them, they have a very lethal, and their comp is still lethal, but with a very short time to kill. Kogkog and Art can just blow up any member of CGA that gets wandered out, but the Cataclysm onto Art, they target him right away. Gengo ulting through, but he will eat an ultimate from Kogkog and go down on that one. That is going to be Grendel pulling him in with the Showstopper, but Ninja going to flash away from that one. Hachimecha caught on the wrong end of this fight, but waiting in the wings now is targeting Grendel, as Aria looks for a re-engage here, trying to find a finish onto Vivid, but is forced to echo ult back out of that one. But the root actually comes through in the end. He is not able to finish off Hachimecha. That is going to be him going down, and Rascal Jester getting the better end of a couple of those. And now they can put themselves up to soul point here by securing this Ocean Drake. A little bit of over-aggression from CGA, and in the sort of brief moment where they lose track of Hachimecha, they capitalize off of it beautifully to find a re-engage.
つ目のドラゴンを抑えることができたと。
さらにドラゴンソウルでいうとやはり一番強いオーシャンドラゴンになっているので、うん、ここ状況としても非常に良かったんですが、
Watch this one more time. The ultimate. So I like the initiative from Gengo, but he tries to just get out of that one, and Kakak makes a great call to utilize the ultimate for him. Then Hachimecha, who had been kind of lost in the shadows, finds a great re-engage there. The root coming through on Aria after the ultimate is really what kind of sealed his fate there, and then not finding the kill onto Hachimecha means that they can grab that ocean drake after the fact.
さあリプレイから戻ってきた先、すぐさまヘラルドに手をつけて CA としては確保を狙っていきます。
全体の装備状況や、まあ、構成的なパワースパイクでいうと今がまさにほぼイーブンのような状態、ただ装備がここからできてくるにつれて CGA 側が有利になってくるので、また RJ としては4つ目のドラゴンソウルというのを確保できるのかどうかというのがこのゲーム勝てるかどうかの一番大きなポイントになりそうですね。
さあ4つ目のそのドラゴンソウルをかけた戦いにはまだ時間がある状況、 CJ としては確かに有利を広げつつありましたが、ここで RJ としても1手を返した。ただもう一度 CJ ここでエンゲージを狙う。さあグレンデルを捕まえて、さあただグレンデルショーストップうまく忍者になって逃げ延びることができている。ただしここがラギングを出してガンガン
Sorry about that. I had to attend to something else. And I could hear the fight breaking out in the other end as Art is going to limp away from that one. Nap now caught out in the reins. And this is... I apologize sincerely. Did have to take care of that. But what I am noticing right away is the value of karma in the hands of Vivid is starting to show a lot more favor. Beautiful flash in from Hachimecha to find and engage onto Aria, but really the target is to get onto Gengo. As the arrow comes through, barely not finishing off Gengo there. As Ninja looks for something here, no ultimate available, the proto belt not going to find his way onto him.
ここで剣魂一滴がガンゴを捉えました。アートにシャットダウンゴールドが入ります。さあそしてここテレポートで寄ってきた。怪我のねさあ
It looks like they will be able to try to finish off Aria here. He has the ultimate available, but the ultimate would not leave him in any better of a position. Opts to save the cooldown and they will finish him off.
そうですね、取れてもボットのインナータワーのみになりそうですね。
The members of Rascal Jester hereFinding their sort of rallying call in this one and are now finding themselves close to pulling the lead back to their favor. But look at where the gold is going on the side of Rascal Jester. All three of their key members have it. Kakog might enjoy a little bit of extra gold in his pocket, but having the ultimate and then immediately is going into the Morella Nomicon is going to offer a great amount of heal cut in an AoE. That is just going to shred through the team fighting aspect for CGA. Now, CGA, on the other hand, is kind of struggling to finish off Art, and the question sort of becomes, are you overcommitting for the dive? You still need to recognize that the rest of Rascal Jester are here. We're not seeing the same kind of hyper carry comp that we had seen prior.They need to start respecting that, as now Gengo has lost the lead that he had before.
このシーンでヨシ選手が間髪入れずにアルティメットでエンゲージをかければいいだけなので、どちらかといえばバルス側の方が辛い立ち回りは求められますね。
なるほど。さあ、オーシャンドレイクまで残り50秒です。ドラゴンのスタック数に余裕があるのはラスカルジェスター
。 I do apologize about
ただこのタイミングでどうですか、抑えたいですか。
抑えないとこの後5分間さらにファームする時間
を I do apologize about the brief interruptions. Did have to attend to something on the side end here.But as the show goes on, Ocean Drake is spawning up in about 15 seconds. While we did talk about earlier how Rascal Jester are not exactly the best users of the Ocean Soul, that doesn't take away from its potency in this kind of a set. So, Yoshi, waiting around in the wings, actually hasn't been spotted in the Dragon Pit yet, and can kind of hide out in there for now. As Yoshi's just kind of standing idly for now. Having not been noticed there, though, he finds his way back out as CGA are trying to find their way in here. They can't exactly start the Drake and burn it down quickly. So the question becomes, are you going to take the fight beforehand? Kai'Sa does take the back here and will teleport back in. Item completion coming in onto him. CGA going to start up the Drake here. Hachimecha with a steal would be great for them here, as Arya is going to look for something. The EQ is denied from Ninja. He uses the Proto Belt to get back and help heal for his team. The Death Charge coming in now, as Gango is not able to deal enough damage to start shredding through Rascal Jester here. They play the defensive type very well. Actually, Ninja specifically coming up huge in this one, but Vivid offering a lot of shielding potential, and then Kakog holding the ultimate and tells they force CGA to overcommit. Beautifully done from the side of Rascal Jester, and a well-earned Ocean Soul at the end of all of it. And we'll watch this one more time. So eyes to Ninja right here. He denies so much of the engage from CGA, denying the EQ with his dredge line. Then immediately recognizing that the fight is moving past him, he immediately starts peeling back, rooting multiple members of CGA. Then Kakog coming in after they've already overcommitted. They've put themselves in that tiny choke area. His ultimate comes in and makes sure that CGA are forced to full retreat from there. And with Ocean Soul picked up on the side of Rascal Jester, they can possibly look to have a little bit more confidence looking for fights here, especially Kakog, who can now be a bit more aggressive with his engages, following up Hachimecha easier, as both of them will be able to reap the benefits of a lot of healing coming through. Looks like they will try to knock down this mid lane turret. Their Baron take, though, is really what's in question. Still is going to be rather slow in that department. As a matter of fact, will be difficult at all to try and knock down that Baron, as they do not have a whole lot of sustained damage to work on that one. So CGA will need to figure out how to navigate that Baron objective. Rascal Jester will have to figure out how to navigate that Baron objective. But meanwhile, on the side of CGA, it gets difficult to try and take the Baron out from under them. You have to deal with a lot of poke damage from Art, as well as if they decide to take a hard engage, it can be very... They don't exactly have the peeling tools to deny the members of Rascal Jester from advancing. Defensive options are limited on the side of CGA, and as it stands right now, Ninja is doing a great job of stuffing a lot of their engage. So in the wake of all of it, Art actually, Rascal Jester, when you put Art on the position where he can deal the damage a bit safer, he does not have to worry about staying alive to be this hyper carry anymore. It's starting to really come up in benefit of him. They will knock down the second turret. The hook comes in onto Grendel, but Kog, meanwhile, has his sights set on the back line. He is going to be forced to back away from that one, but not after taking a decent amount of HP from them with him. Yoshi's Stone Plate not going to save him for long, and goes golden, does Kog, baiting Arya forward. A beautiful Zhonya's actually baits eagerness from Arya to try and find something in this one, but Rascal Jester are the ones who come up in the benefit. It is going to be the members of Rascal Jester knocking down the inhibitor. Are they going to look for the game end? It looks like they're going to try, as Hachimecha diving back onto Gango, forcing him out of the fight immediately. Meanwhile, Grendel and Aatrox are being picked apart. That is going to be Rascal Jester finding an ace and cleaning up this game. It will be 2-2 in the series, and Rascal Jester will bring us to match point. Beautiful stuff from both sides, but Rascal Jester figured out how they needed to answer the snowball from the side of CGA, and it works beautifully. And this is why I love to see Best of 5 series, the adaptations that we're seeing from both teams to kind of play different styles, adjust to each other's play, is coming up beautifully. And now, as we crest into this next match, don't go anywhere, as you want to see what the last notes of this one will be before we play out and we see who moves on to the second round of spring playoffs.
Work while